Hello everybody. We're gonna booking, Wachenigo, Crafton leading, Gregson second, Sorter, Harrison Burns, Todd Gilman, Friesen, Grollo, Rhodes, Christopher Bell, and Austin Citrick, the top 10. And let's get going. Here we go. We'll fly back in here. We'll fly in here. Can Johnny Sauter grab that second spot on this start? No, Sauter can't. Gregson, hang in. 12th up there. Is that... Wow. Down, Greg... Ah, Gregson. Come on, Gregson. Go, Gregson! Oh my god, Gregson. No, Gregson. Come on, Gregson. Come on, Gregson. Don't mess up, Gregson. Come on, Gregson. What a move. Oh my god. I don't want to see you, Kyle Busch. I don't like you. I like Crafton. I'm probably the only one that does. But I want Gregson to win. If I like seeing first time winner. So go, Gregson. One or Gregson.
Potentially winning this race, and big for some of those other teams that are trying to
battle Matt
Crafton in the championship, because that means Crafton doesn't clinch a spot in the Final Four at Homestead, Miami.
Sauter. Well, don't let Sauter pass you, Crafton. Sauter is a good truck, and he might be able to catch Gregson if he gets past Crafton.
Johnny Sauter working on Matt Crafton for second. That's Harrison behind them in fourth. Todd Gill in fifth. Three KVM machines in the top
five.
Line.
To go.
I'm not sure there's enough time for Johnny Sauter to get by Matt Crafton to chase down.
Harrison Burns is in fourth. Todd Gilman's in fifth, by the way. How was Stuart Friesen in sixth? Should have won at Eldora, but Friesen messed up.
Well, that was an impressive restart. We saw Noah Gregson after a rough start to the season come here in the spring and run in the top five, so he likes this track, and he is gone.
Gregson is gone, right? Michael.
The third spot.
Burns gonna pass Sauter.
Three to go for.
Three to go. Come on. Yes. Come on, Gregson.
So much.
Oh, wow, Gregson.
The course of this race, talked about those drivers that were battling for the championship.
Come on, Gregson.
Said, this is a place where
I know I keep saying come on, Gregson, but come on.
Spoiler, and it looks like it's gonna be the 18 of Noah Gregson.
Two to go.
Two to go.
Come on, don't mess up in his laps. Don't mess up in his last two laps, Gregson. Come on, bring it on.
All the others, like a Crafton or a Sauter, would love to see a yellow right now. Gregson is just praying
no,
that it stays green.
No yellows. And final lap. Gregson, come on, don't mess up here. Come on, Gregson.
What a special day for that young man.
Gregson. Off the turn three. Noah Gregson is gonna win. Yes. 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 Noah Gregson. Crap. Yeah. There you go. Crap. Yeah. Yeah, that was nice. That was amazing. That works. I'm about to restart.
Noah Gregson, the 10th. The 10th person.
Gregson.
In Martinsville, and you heard his crew chief, Marcus Richmond.
Yes, we can have a burnout here. Yes, there you go. Noah Gregson.
And Noah Gregson, they missed the playoffs. They felt like they were a team capable of challenging for a championship, and they were so disappointed that they didn't make the playoffs.
Here we go. Noah Gregson.
Shows they are every bit the team that will end up winning the championship later this year.
Remember, we interviewed him after race. He finished second. He was in tears for not winning that race. He might be in tears here today, too, but different kind of tears.
Yeah, this has got to be a great feeling. When was the last time you did something for the first time? Well, he's getting to do something very special for the first time here today in Martinsville.
Gregson was second earlier this season in Canada, as Phil mentioned, when they felt like that was really their opportunity to make the playoffs. This will be a day
yes.
he will never forget. Noah Gregson, his first career win, and he did it at Martinsville.
Copyrighted telecast may not be reproduced, retransmitted, or used in any form without the authorized written consent of NASCAR Broadcasting. NASCAR would like to thank all of our fans for your support, and we hope you enjoy today's broadcast.
Oh, I did.
Fall foliage is out on this college football Saturday in the heart of America.
Wait, is that it?
Sunflower Showdown coming up next. Now, I know you guys in Martinsville love those crazy hot dogs. We got tailgating that takes a backseat to no one here in the great Midwest. It is the great rivalry of Kansas State and Kansas. And Alex Delta, the quarterback for K-State, coming off his best performance yet. We'll see how the Jayhawks fare against the Hall of Famer Bill Snyder.
Is that it?
Looking for career win number 206. Now let's get back to Martinsville.
Oh, it's not it. I was going to say.
Thanks, Tim. Well, that one is yes. really as exciting as what we've had here today. It's going to be some kind of game between K-State and Kansas. How about Noah Gregson getting his first career win? Celebrate with a little fence climbing. That's what young kids do. That's how strong
that's what Noah Gregson does.
Matt Crafton finished second. He's with Caitlin.
Yeah, his fifth top five performance been so far this year. Matt, anything you would have done differently looking back there on that last restart?
Pick the outside. That really sucks. But the bottom rubber's up so bad, and the top doesn't have to rubber on it. We would pick it up and get it on our tires. And that I was on the outside at the very beginning of the race, and it worked pretty good. And I'm thinking to myself, I got tight in the middle, got that run right there at the end. I'm like, if he can roll up top, I'm going to be in trouble. But it would have been absolutely crazy to think that I'm going to pick the outside of Martinsville with 10 to go. But yeah. I had to go to the bottom, and it didn't work out today.
Thank you. Matt Crafton, the runner-up here at Martinsville. Harmony.
Well, Caitlin, I got Johnny Sauer. Your truck was up front. You were the dominant truck. Got back in traffic. What was the issue with the truck that you fought coming down the stretch?
Well, I mean, you just can't give up track position, obviously. Our ISM connection was good. Joe and all the guys at GMS did a great job. We just, anymore, it's so competitive. You can't give up anything. You know, it's not like, years ago, I could come here and lose 15 spots and get back up there. But it's just, everybody's so tight now. So you get out clean air, it's crazy how much better your stuff is. So all in all, good effort. We just missed a little bit there. And whatever, we got good racetracks coming up. We'll get it going.
Johnny Sauer, he's third.
Texas, Phoenix, and then obviously Homestead.
Spots, and he's referring to that pit stop where they gave up a handful. They came in first, and they went out.
Last up there.
Victory lane. The celebration.
I'm an idiot.
Don't
listen to me.
This is after he already climbed the fence. Oh, what a mess down here in victory lane. A long time coming for this young man.
Noah Gregson.
Close calls. Noah Gregson, you told me before the race you were comfortable on the outside. Did you know you could get past Matt Crafton on that final restart?
Oh, yeah. It's really tough. Racing against these veterans. Those last night 40 laps with Johnny Sauer beat off my back bumper. He did that earlier to us in the spring, and I wasn't going to let him pass me again like that. So, got that caution there at the end, and you can't pass on the outside of Martinsville. And I did it.
How did you do it? How are you good on the outside like that?
Just all the hard work. I've had the monkey on my back this whole year. I've been asked pretty much every day, when are you going to get that win? When are we going to put up a banner at College Motorsports? And just thankful for everyone, Dustin Ash, Jefferson Pitts Racing, Jim Ianley, everyone who's brought me up through the ranks. Racing, I'm so very thankful. Thank you to Switch, Mobile Strike, TRD, Kyle, Samantha Bush, everyone in NASCAR Texas Roadhouse. I have my ride helmet on today. I'm super comfy. And man, I'm blown away. We're going to get a banner up at KBM. We're taking home the Granddaddy Watch, or whatever they call it. My crew chief, he likes to call it the granddaddy watch or granddaddy clock. So we're taking it home. Thank you, Marcus Richmond. Thank you to all these guys out behind me.
Thank you. Congratulations on victory number one. Doug Gregson is a winner in the Camping World Truck Series.
I don't think he's putting that clock on his wrist.
The granddaddy watch.
Yeah, I don't think it's happened. That's the grandfather clock. They've been giving this trophy away since 1964. That's what happens when you're 18 years old, right?
You know, I was really impressed with that last restart, but the job that young man did holding off Johnny Sauter for 30, 40 laps, Johnny all over him, didn't slip a wheel. His crew chief said, don't make a mistake. Well, heck, he's going to knock me into a mistake, but he didn't let it happen, put himself in a position to win the race.
He doesn't win the race if Johnny Sauter gets by him and he has to restart third. No way to win the race.
Yeah, we thought Sauter was in really the most enviable position by being in third place and starting on the inside, but it was actually Gregson who got it done on the outside. But maybe this is the save of the race because Sauter was trying to get by Gregson. He gave him a good bump, but Noah was able to hold on to that position, and because he held on right there, he was able to start that restart where he did to set himself up for the pass for the win.
I thought Gregson was done after. Like, I didn't think he was going to win if he started out a little tightly.
Christopher Bell came in as our championship leader. He finished eighth today, Caitlin.
Yeah, top 10 effort for him. Bouncing back, contact with the 88 while you were leading. What happened from your vantage point there?
Ow.
We were on two tires, and I was struggling at that point. And, I don't know. So slight contact, but I was struggling at that point, just trying to hang on. And once the 88 got there, I was really going to try and let him go there and get back in line. I knew I didn't have a truck that could win, but I don't know. I'm sure it wasn't on purpose there, but overall it was a good day for us, and we salvaged some points out of the day because we really
still think they're going to win the championship. Christopher Bell,
so we got the next best thing. Our JBL Tundra was really strong throughout the second stage, and I was able to move forward and get some good points there, and then to finish eighth and see my teammate get a win. That was really big for him, and really cool to see that.
Thank you. Christopher Bell getting his 18th top 10 performance so far this year.
Christopher Bell. For one race here in round two.
Bell, Sauter, Kraft, and Rhodes above the cut line.
Christopher Bell, John Sauter, Matt
on the outside looking in, Cindric, and Nemechek.
Above the cut line. And speaking of Ben Rhodes, he's with Hermie.
Well, Ben, you see it already. Plus 11 on the cut line. Not good enough to sleep well at night yet. Early on, your truck was really, really fast up front, battling for the top three spots. You ended up ninth. What happened?
Yeah, you know, whenever I had a fast 8x Tundra today, I feel like it was a top five truck. I feel like we got ourselves a little bit behind on that
track. Vegas,
we came in, we thought some of the other trucks were going to come in, and nobody came in. So we went to the back, and new tires just didn't mean anything today. And we saw time and time again, guys with new tires just couldn't come through the field. And I feel like that was our mistake today. Then after we got going, we got bounced around like a pinball out there. It's Martinsville. And gosh, I'm glad I come here with my teammates and all my friends on my team, because it's just such a wild race, and I feel like it actually broke some stuff on our truck. It actually stopped traveling going into the corners, and I could put my splitter on top of the curb going around the corner. So just a crazy day, but all in all, just happy we survived.
It's Ben Rhodes, Vince.
Thank you, Hermie. Well, wow. Noah Gregson puts on that winner sticker.
We'll go to
Texas next week. Round two coming your way next Friday night from Texas Motor Speedway.
Yeah, kiss that.
And we're not done yet for the rest of this weekend. More racing coming your way. Cup race.